It's a huge honor. It's a huge honor for me because, as we saw during the ceremony, there is a lot of journalists that suffer very much more than I'm suffering now. I'm living my own small hell, I could say, but we saw people in real hell, tortured, killed, imprisoned. So it is a great honor for me. I see it as a recognition for the work I did, but also as a sign. Poland, my country, is not a country like Iran, where journalists are tortured, or Russia, where journalists are killed, but Poland is dangerously sleeping to be a country like Russia. And my book, I was given the prize for, describes a part of this situation. It's a book about dangerous ties to Russia. It's a book about Polish Minister of Defense, Antoni Macierewicz, and his dangerous ties to Russian mafia and the Russian secret services. And for this book, the minister didn't dare to sue me, or nor he denounced me for defamation, because the book is very thoroughly, precisely documented. Instead of this, he denounced me to a military prosecutor for terrorism. He did the same thing we heard about, we heard is done in the cases of Turkish, Syrian journalists. They are accused of terrorism. I'm not imprisoned like them. We are not at this step. But if we don't fight for freedom and truth, we can awake one day in Poland, which will be exactly like Russia or Iran. Nobody knows. My case is very strange because the minister denounced me 4 months ago. And I wasn't heard by the prosecutor. I didn't see a prosecutor. I didn't see a warrant, an invitation for an interrogation, any official information about it. Instead of this, the prosecutor's office is going to media and talking about how it is examining my case. They say loudly that they are seriously examining the minister's complaint about my terrorism. It's a very strange thing. I was a journalist, columnist, publicist, fiction writer, but when the Minister of Defense, when Antoni Macierewicz was nominated a Minister of Defense at the end of the year 2015, I understood that there is very strange, that something very strange is going on, because during the electoral campaign, the Law and Justice Party, the Minister's Party, promised to the people that he will never be a minister of defense. He is very, he is hated and feared even by many people that vote the Law and Justice Party that rules in Poland. So I told to myself, okay, I have to think like the American journalists do. If you don't know what is going on, it must be about the money. So I tried to discover who the minister is as businessman. And so I found his ties to former communist secret services and to Russia. Because my accusations are true. He wants to scar other journalists. He shows to all Polish journalists, don't investigate about my Russian ties if you don't want to be denounced to a military prosecutor and accused of terrorism. He he uses Russian methods to cover his Russian ties. The ruling party wants to destroy Gazeta Wyborcza. They don't publish any advertising or communication in Gazeta Wyborcza. They forbidden the government and administration offices to buy Gazeta Wyborcza. They even forbidden the courts to buy Gazeta Wyborcza. And money advertising, money advertisers at the beginning started to fear to publish their advertising in Gazeta Wyborcza. But the situation is changing because Gazeta Wyborcza did a huge step in the future with transition from paper to online reporting. It's the first success story is the first Polish success story of newspapers that tried to be paid online. Wyborcza is selling online a lot, and so the strategy of the government is failing. It's a huge danger for press freedom in the country. Once, because the government is trying to destroy the free press. They started with economical methods, like the one I described in the case of Gazeta Wyborcza. But now they are trying to impose an anti-European legislation that will forbid to newspapers and media to be owned by non-Polish capital. And they believe they can do more pressure on Polish businessmen than on the foreign ones, which is obvious because the Polish businessmen somehow have to do business with Polish government or to act in the environment strongly influenced by the Polish government. Many of them start to lose faith. They think maybe people don't need us. Many people doesn't want to read the newspapers and wants only to see information on social media. But the case of Gazeta Wyborcza shows that we can still fight and win. So I want to tell all journalists, not only in Poland, don't be afraid or governments, don't be afraid even of the internet, which can be very dangerous, as we saw, for example, in the United States during the last campaign. We have to fight for freedom and truth, because without freedom and truth, our life is nothing. RSF is very important and can be even crucial, because the journalist, Polish journalist, must see that the world journalism, independent world journalism, is helping them and supporting them. And what happened today, this prize, is of enormous importance. I think that many friends of mine that started to lose faith in the sense and of fighting for the truth now will regain this faith.
That's how it should be. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.